Plumsail Forms is a product that allows you to create custom modern UI responsive forms for SharePoint. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Plumsail Forms for SharePoint 2019. Click Start Trial and enter your name and email. Then select Forms for SharePoint 2019 and submit. You will need to download the installer and run the installer as the admin. It's very important to run the installer as the admin and to run it on your SharePoint server. Don't run it on your PC, run it on SharePoint server. Follow the wizard steps. It will check if you are running the installer on the server or not, and it will check if you have the product installed already or not. Once all the checks are complete, you'll need to read the EULA and agree. Then you can select which site collections you want to activate the app for. So select site collections. You can select multiple. I will select just one for this example and proceed to install the product. It will take some time to install, so you can take a coffee break here, for example. So wait for it to install, and after it's done, you can see that it completed successfully. Just close the app. And you can go back to the installation instructions. So now you can check that the feature has been activated for site collection specified. Go to site information, and go to site settings, and check site collection features. As you can see, Plumsail Forms is active. So it has installed and activated correctly. And you need to make sure that you have an app catalog created. You can check it in central administration. Once it opens, click Manage Apps. Select the correct application. Go to the app catalog via the link, and as you can see, we already have an app catalog. If you don't have one, you will need to create it. So on the site, once you've installed the app, a new button should appear in the ribbon. We see it here, and here you'll find the last steps that you need to complete to install the app. One of them is to download the package and to upload it to the app catalog. Select the package, upload it, and it's very important that you make it available to all sites in your organization. So after that is done, you just need to install the desktop editor. Okay, agree, install, and when it finishes the installation, you can use it. You can also install it on your PC, not necessary to run it from the server. It can be run from any PC as long as you have the credentials to connect to, well, and the connection to the server. You can connect. You only need full control permission to the site that you want to edit, and you need connection to SharePoint. So I'm going to connect to the root using my current Windows user, but you don't have to use current Windows user. There are plenty of other authentication options. So select the list. I'm going to select my example list. And once it loads, you can start creating your first form So you can see the SharePoint fields available on the left, and SharePoint fields are the fields that are going to be saved to SharePoint after the form is submitted. So they are taken straight from the list. So if you need another field, just create a new column, and all columns will be available here as fields. You can play the width. I'm adding accordion controller connect. I'm adding accordion container to the form, and I'm populating it with fields. One section is going to be contacts, another is going to be documents. And instead of attachments field, I will add list or library control, so I can connect another document library to it. In order to bind documents to a specific item, I will actually need to go to the documents library and create a lookup field here. So it's going to be a field called parent, and it's going to be a lookup to the parent list. So it will be associated with a specific element or specific item where you upload documents. You can also edit the view or create a new view, and all these changes are going to be visible in list or library. So I will just hide my technical lookup field called parent, and I will move comment a little closer. Okay, so here you select the lookup field which you want to be automatically populated, and you can just save all three forms at once. It takes some time to do so, and be very careful with it because you can overwrite some existing differences. But if you are just creating first forms, you can just save three at once and it will save you some time, so you don't have to create them all. So after the form is saved, you can minimize the editor or even close it, go to the list, and by default you will see this default SharePoint forms, but you just refresh the page and new form will load, so all the links will be updated, and once you click new, you will be redirected to the correct form. So as you can see here, it has loaded. I can enter some example data, for example, company name John Sons. So put some example address, Magnolia Drive, why not? And it can be New York and New York State. And it can be Manager Johnson, for example, doesn't matter. Here you can upload documents. So I will just upload this one, and the file is uploaded, and once we save the form, it will be automatically tied to this particular company, so to this particular item. So we'll add a comment here. As you can see, you can edit it right here, and then click here and it will save all the changes, and then you can save the form, and all the information will be saved. But for example, you don't want the form to open in a new window like this. You might want it to open in a panel, and that's also available. So you just go here and you specify which forms you want to open in a panel, how big you want it to be. So let's set them all to large, so they take as much space as possible. And once it saves, we can go back to the list. Okay, refresh the page. Click new. And as you can see, the form now opens in a panel, just like default SharePoint forms. So let's create another example company, for example, Emily's Flowers. Give it some random contact information, something like business road, for example. And let's say it will be New Orleans in Louisiana. And we can upload two files at once. You can upload as many as you want, just an example. And we can edit them as well, just right here. Don't forget to save by clicking on the check mark. Populate the next document. Save this one. And then click save on the form itself to save the item. As you can see, both items have been saved, and you can open them in display form and check out the data. But as you can see, this library is still editable on display form. You can open display form in particular in the editor. And you can set list all library to read-only mode here. Then save display form only. So that's pretty much it. As you can see, the items are saved successfully and the data is displayed. Documents are tied to a specific item. And you can also go to edit form from display form right here. That's all. I hope you enjoyed the video. Go check out the product itself. It has 30 days trial and many more features are available. So, thank you for watching.